In this video, you learn the step-by-step process to understand and dive deep into Web3 and blockchain technologies, and I'm super excited. Hi, I'm Francesco, and I create free Web3 content on different platforms. If you want to know more, just check the links below. And now, let's start! Where to start, and an important question. What is Web3? In this case, what I'd recommend is an article by Nader Debit published on FreeCodeCamp. What is Web3? The decentralized internet of the future explained. In this article, there are some core concepts explained. It's really worth your time reading it. Do you want a roadmap? There are many of them. My favorite one so far is by Vittorio Rivabella, The Complete Web3 and Solidity Development Roadmap. It covers many topics I'll talk about in this video, and it's great to have a list of things to learn so you don't miss any of them. And now let's start listing some of the core concepts you should understand. This is what I call blockchain fundamentals. The difference between Web 1, Web 2, and Web 3. What is a blockchain? What is a distributed ledger? Some basics of cryptocurrencies and the concept of wallet, a very important one related to the identity. Block explorers, that are tools that enable you to search for real-time and historical information about the blockchain. Blockchain oracles, entities that connect the blockchain to external system. An introduction to NFTs. What is a DAO, decentralized autonomous organization? And last but not least, what is a smart contract? And an introduction to DApps, decentralized apps. This is the core. They are not specific to a single blockchain, but they are important and relevant no matter the blockchain you want to focus on. And yes, there are many blockchains. Ethereum, Solana, Polkadot, Polygon, etc. Did you know that IBM and Oracle have their own blockchains? So which is the best blockchain to start with? There is not a correct answer to this question, but I recommend to start with Ethereum. Why Ethereum? It has a solid ecosystem and a bigger community, and this means that if you have a problem, you are more likely to find the solution. Also, since it has a bigger ecosystem, there are more unbiased resources to learn it. Every blockchain asserts that they are the best, and Ethereum is not an exception. But you can find more people who create articles, videos, and tutorials just for educational purposes. So after you choose a blockchain, in this case Ethereum, there are some core and basic concepts you should know that are specific of that blockchain. In the case of Ethereum, Ethereum accounts and transactions, blocks for the Ethereum blockchain and how do they work for Ethereum, EVM, which stands for Ethereum Virtual Machine, what is gas for Ethereum, the concepts of nodes and clients, networks and node providers. There are many of them. Moreover, what happened with the merge in September 2022, what is the beacon chain and what are side chains. And there are also some advanced concepts specific of the blockchain that you might want to know. In the case of Ethereum, the Ethereum white paper, which is a technical document that describes the Ethereum blockchain and the Ethereum platform. It was published in 2013 by Vitalik Buterin, the co-founder of Ethereum. The Ethereum trilemma is a concept that refers to the trade-offs that must be made in order to design a blockchain that is, at the same time, decentralized, secure, and scalable. It's very hard to achieve all three of them simultaneously, and for the most curious who really want to understand the math behind Ethereum, there is the Yellow Paper, a technical document that provides a formal specification of the Ethereum virtual machine. It was written by Dr. Gavin Wood, one of the co-founders of Ethereum, and was published in 2014. And now it's time to choose a language. Whatever blockchain you decide to learn, there are one or more programming languages that you can use to create a smart contract with that specific blockchain. In the case of Ethereum, we can choose between two languages. Viper, more recommended if you are a Python developer, and Solidity, a good choice whether you are a JavaScript or Python developer. My choice and what I recommend to learn first is Solidity. Solidity is an object-oriented high-level language for implementing smart contracts. It's a curly bracket language designed to target the Ethereum Virtual Machine, EVM. It's influenced by C++, Python, and JavaScript. It's statically typed and it supports inheritance, libraries, and complex user-defined types. A great way to start learning Solidity is the official documentation. I will also put a link to a good Solidity cheat sheet that I created in the description below. Another great resource that you can use to start is Remix IDE, a web-based integrated development environment for the Solidity programming language, which is used to write smart contracts for the Ethereum blockchain. It is designed to make it easy for developers to write, test, and deploy smart contracts on the Ethereum platform, as it already has everything you need in order to start with Solidity development. And if you want to make a hello world using Solidity and Remix, you can check this link. And now, tutorials. There are some very good online tutorials to learn Solidity. I'll mention three of them. Crypto Zombies, an interactive coding tutorial that teaches users how to build their own decentralized application on the Ethereum blockchain, having fun with a zombie game. Learn Web3 Tutorials, an amazing and complete series that will guide you from freshman to senior level. And Alchemy University, a new series released at the end of 2022. Definitely worth a try. I tried all three of them during some of my live streams. I leave all the links in the description. And now, Solidity videos. Let me mention my favorite YouTube channels and videos to learn Solidity. Smart Contract Programmer YouTube channel, very clean and straight to the point videos. Dapp University YouTube channel with Solidity Crash Courses videos, and finally, two great and complete videos, which cover everything about blockchain, both of them by Patrick Collins, and both of them are on the FreeCodeCamp YouTube channel, one for Python developers, 16 hours long, and one for JavaScript developers, 32 hours long. It took me 3 months to watch it all. And now let me introduce you to some Solidity tools and frameworks. MetaMask, a browser extension that allows users to interact with the Ethereum blockchain. It serves as a digital wallet for storing and managing Ethereum and other Ethereum-based tokens, as well as a platform for interacting with decentralized applications on the Ethereum network. Truffle, an open-source development framework written in JavaScript that provides a set of tools and libraries for building and deploying smart contracts and decentralized applications. It's designed to make it easy for developers to build, test, and deploy their projects, and it includes many features such as contract compilation, linking, testing, and deployment. Hard Hat, probably my favorite so far. It's written in TypeScript and it's similar to Truffle. It's designed to be flexible and easy to use, and it has great documentation and a collaborative community. Brownie, an open-source Python library for developing and testing smart contracts and decentralized applications, compatible with both Python 2 and Python 3 that can be used in combination with other Ethereum development tools such as MetaMask and Truffle. And last, Foundry, the new kid on the block, a portable and modular toolkit for Ethereum application development written in Rust, focused on speed. Let me spend 1 minute to talk about frontend. When you create a decentralized application, you connect it to a website users can interact with. And here is a good news. If you are a frontend developer, you don't have to learn a new framework or specific framework for the blockchain. Everything you know is still relevant and you can use any framework you want. You just have to connect it with a library. to make it interact with the blockchain. The most famous ones are Web3.js, Ethers.js, Alchemy Web3 API, and React Morales. To store data on the blockchain, the best way is to use a decentralized storage. Let me introduce you to three decentralized storage technologies used in blockchain development. IPFS. It's a fascinating technology. It stands for Interplanetary File System, and it's a peer-to-peer protocol. It aims to create a decentralized and distributed network for storing and sharing files, in which users can access and retrieve files from anywhere on the network rather than having to rely on a central server or authority. Filecoin, a decentralized storage network based on IPFS that uses a cryptocurrency of the same name to incentivize users to contribute their storage space and bandwidth to the network. And last, R-Wave, a decentralized and permanent storage platform that utilizes a new type of data structure called a block wave. It allows users to store data in a distributed and decentralized manner, making it resistant to censorship and tampering. I want to mention some mid-level tools. They are not necessary to start, but when you create some real-world smart contracts, they become more and more useful. Let's start with two tools to test smart contracts. Waffle, created to be simple, easy to learn, and fast, and Ganache, a dev environment that allows you to emulate the Ethereum blockchain so that you can interact with smart contracts in your own private blockchain. OpenZeppelin is a library of reusable, secure, and tested code written in Solidity. It provides a set of robust contracts and frameworks that make it easier for developers to build and deploy secure, decentralized applications on Ethereum. Wallet Connect is an open source protocol that helps implement connections between wallets and decentralized apps. Chainlink is a decentralized oracle network that provides reliable, tamper-proof data to smart contracts on any blockchain. Oracles are third-party services that provide external data to smart contracts, allowing them to interact with the real world. The Graph is a protocol for indexing data from a blockchain that allows you to build APIs that can be then queried using GraphQL. These subgraphs can be used to build decentralized applications that need to access data from multiple sources in an unified, easy-to-use format. Do you need to code everything from scratch every single time? The answer is no, because there are many Web3 SDKs, software development kits, that can make your developer life way easier, but I recommend using them only if you understand what they do, because otherwise you might get lost while creating your decentralized applications. And there are many of them. The most important ones are Alchemy, Third Web, and Morales. And finally, the best possible way to learn blockchain technologies is to build projects. To get inspiration, you can check solidityexample.org, where you can find many projects you can take and expand in your favorite way. Wow, those were a lot of resources. It took a while just to mention them. But before we say goodbye, let me give you two more tips to learn Web3. 1. Learn in public. The best and fastest way to learn is to do it in public. Create tips, threads, articles, videos, whatever you want, just to document your journey and notice the improvements over time. It's a bit awkward at the beginning, but it helps you to learn Web3 faster. For example, about 1 year ago, I created a GitHub repository called Free Web3 Resources, and I started populating it with all the good and free resources to learn Web3 that I found. If you want to be part of this project, I leave the link in the description below. And the last tip is that the best way to learn something is to not do it alone. So join a community. I'll mention my three favorite Web3 ones. Developer DAO, a group of thousands of builders, very active and focused on projects. Learn Web3 DAO, probably the best Web3 community you can join at the moment. Super supportive, great people there, just join it and check it by yourself. 4C, in case you are a Web3 developer focused on content creation, you can join 4C, the cool community of content creators. We have a dedicated group just for Web3 members, and we work on the repository I mentioned before, the Free Web3 Resources GitHub repository, to make it the best free Web3 project ever. So that's it for this video. I leave all the links that I've mentioned in the description below. If you have any questions, just drop a comment, and good luck in learning Web3. Goodbye.